Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattlesnakes and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it and I hope that this video finds you well. In today's episode, we're going to be taking a closer look at a 2019 release. This one by the company M. Mikalev is called Desire Toxic, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin my fragrance review of Desire Toxic by M. Mikalev, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content, if you like fragrance reviews here on YouTube, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, special guests, interviews, and a whole lot more, any sort of fragrance-related content, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. I would really appreciate it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. This way, whenever I do put out these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. So here we have a fragrance that came out in 2019. I recall watching a ton of other reviews online, and it seems like so many people are praising it. And I feel very happy and ecstatic that the company was willing to collaborate with me and also give you a very special coupon code. If you are international, you can use the code RETALESCENCE15 to get 15% off your order. This is valid only for the next 7 days. And if you are within the US, you can use the code RETALESCENCEUS15 to get 15% off your purchase of this fragrance. It cannot be combined with any other promos or any other offers on the website, but I am going to leave the code down below to where you can check it out if you are interested in purchasing this fragrance. And also, if for some reason the code is not working for you, you can always send the brand an email or you can send them a DM on Instagram. They are very responsive. And so I originally discovered this brand many, many, many years ago. As a matter of fact, I was visiting a boutique in New York City and I tried so many of their fragrances and I fell in love with so many of their offerings. And here we have one that I think is the perfect fragrance for this time of the year, just because it has a lot of these darker and sometimes sweeter ingredients that I typically gravitate towards for this time of the year. So we're talking about the cinnamon, we're talking about a spicy quality, a little musk, it's a little mossy, it has that tonka bean vanilla cinnamon thing going on in here, but it also has this really interesting note of hemp right beneath this bergamot and lemon introduction. I'm really excited to tell you more in regards to my thoughts on the smell. Let's start things off with the presentation. So the box for this one is really nice. It has this really nice pattern on the sides here and this glossy finish. And I should mention that it comes with this plastic sleeve, which protects the box. So the box opens up to reveal a podium in which the bottle rests. And you also have this little informational booklet on the inside. All of your pertinent information may be located on the bottom of the box. And the bottle for this one has this matte, deep blue finish to it. And it also has this same texture that you will find on the box. So there's a sticker on the bottom with your information. The cap for this fragrance does click into place very securely. You can pick it up from the cap, but I would say don't because this is a very heavy bottle. And the distribution on the atomizer is very wide. Let's continue with the smell. So as soon as this fragrance opens up, you are going to get that brightness in the opening. So you definitely have the bergamot and the lemon, and they're kind of vying for attention. Maybe the lemon is a little bit stronger than the bergamot, but of course they are volatile top notes. So we can't really expect them to last for a very long time in this fragrance, but they really just capture your attention in the opening, and then they very quickly regress to the background. And then what you're going to get is this spicy and sweet concoction, and I really love that sweetness that's going on in here. So you definitely get a little bit of that tonka bean creamy vibe that's going on in the base, and yes, it is counterparted with this note of musk. But the musk ingredient doesn't come across animalic, it doesn't come across overwhelming or like a burden or anything like that. And it actually adds a smooth, clean, and billowy quality to the fragrance. And I know a lot of times when we're talking about animalic ingredients, whether it be musk, civet, castoreum, ambergris, hyrax, whatever the case may be, they add this raunchy quality to the fragrance and you don't have that going on in here. As a matter of fact, I'm picking up on a quality that is not listed in the note breakdown. I actually get like this tobacco vibe from it. And I think it's that sweet sort of creamy tobacco nuance that really makes me fall in love with this fragrance. And so it has that cherry-like tobacco that's in here. It doesn't smell like a moist, pipe tobacco. It doesn't smell like Cavendish tobacco, but it smells like a cherry flavored smooth tobacco that has that musky quality in the base. And yes, it also has this hemp note, but nothing about this fragrance makes it smell like that kind of a substance, if you know what I'm getting at. It just comes across smelling very smooth, very bold, and I think it's the type of fragrance that would do really well this time of the year. So today it was actually in the high 50s, so it goes without saying that it was a little chilly today. It was also raining quite a bit here in northern New Jersey. And so when we do have that chilly weather, it can kind of be expected that I'm going to gravitate towards these darker, spicier, cinnamon tobacco type fragrances, and this is definitely one of them. Now, just to add a little bit of commentary on that green mossy thing that's going on in the base, I do get it. It's there and I'm smelling it. I pick up on it, but I don't think it's overwhelming in any way. I know a lot of times whenever we think of these verdant accents, whether it be oak moss or fir or pine or whatever, we're typically inclined to think about fragrances that might be reminiscent of like the late 70s, 80s. That is not going on in this fragrance. It really just adds that nice sort of masculine characteristic in the base, but there's enough of that sweetness that I think makes this a shared composition, and so it can be enjoyed mutually by both men and women. I'm personally loving this fragrance. I know I featured it in a list already on my channel, but it's definitely a fragrance that I'm gonna be talking about a lot more in the years to come because I think it's a very well pieced together fragrance. Bravo, Mika Lef, for this wonderful composition from 2019. Let's go ahead and finish things off with the overall assessment. So first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, I know tobacco fragrances are a dime a dozen, whether it comes to designer fragrances, niche fragrances. So we often rely on there being this indication or this element in there that really offsets the fragrance and makes it different from other offerings on the market that might be similar. And I think in the case of this fragrance, it's the cinnamon, the moss, and the hemp. And that really adds this nice character and nice dimension to the fragrance. And the overall smell on this one is very pleasant. So despite the fact that it has these spicier qualities, it does have that tobacco nuance that I talked about. Even though there's no tobacco in the note breakdown, I just want to reiterate that point. I do kind of get something tobacco-y as far as my nose is concerned, and I personally love the smell. In terms of the overall smell, like I said, I do think it's one that people are going to be drawn to. There's nothing about it that's overly aggressive or domineering or anything like that. It's not going to turn anybody off. It is the type of fragrance that you are likely to get complimented on without it being a fresh designer sporty fragrance, if you know what I mean. Longevity is great. You're gonna get about 8 hours on your skin. The projection was really good for the first hour and a half. It didn't start to sit closer to the skin until about that 6.5 hour mark. And I would say it never really radiated beyond an arm's length, but it will get you noticed for sure. Versatility is very good. I would be more inclined to wear it in the colder weather, and you can probably get away with wearing it in the spring as well, especially if it's a little chilly outside. However, in the dead of summer, there are other more citrus dominant fragrances, especially ones from the brand that you can probably wear instead of this one. But now we are in the heart of fall. We're going to be in the winter soon. So I think now is the best time, the absolute best time to wear this fragrance. And in terms of the versatility regarding it being a shared composition, I do think it's perfectly unisex, and I think this one can be worn dressed up or dressed down, but there is this formal quality about it, and so I would say that for the price that you're paying, despite the discount, I think it's a really great fragrance to wear on a special occasion when you really want to make a statement. In terms of the presentation, I really do enjoy the presentation. My final verdict is I think this is an awesome fragrance for the colder weather. If those notes sound appealing or enticing to you, whether it be the tonka bean, the patchouli, the moss, the musk, the cinnamon, the hemp, the citrus in here, this is a really unique fragrance with a tobacco edge to it. And I would definitely recommend that you go out there and try it, especially if you are a fan of that particular classification. And again, if you are interested in picking this one up, I do want to mention that there is a current promotion going on in collaboration with my channel. So a very special thank you to the folks over at Mika Lef for making this happen. If you are international, you can use the code RedOlescence15 to get 15% off your purchase of this fragrance, valid for the next 7 days only. And if you are within the United States, you can use the code RedOlescenceUS15 to get 15% off this fragrance. So thank you so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate it. That was my review of Desir Toxic by M. Mikalev. If you own or have tried this fragrance, or if you're curious about this brand in any capacity, I always love to hear from you. I love the interaction. Please go ahead and leave a comment down below. I always love to reply to your comments and read what you have to say. And of course, if you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video, I would really appreciate it if you could support this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for watching. I love you all. We'll see you soon. Bye.